everyone. I'm Rachel, and I'm a software engineer on the .NET MAUI team. And today, I'm here to chat with you about creating accessible apps with .NET MAUI. So before we get into it, I figure we remind ourselves why we should care about accessibility. So there are over 1 billion people who currently experience some form of disability. That makes up around 15% of the global population. Designing for accessibility is not limited to people experiencing disabilities, and the best solutions actually benefit everyone. And you can see here some everyday examples that we're familiar with. For example, voice assistance on GPS, closed captioning on videos, and the raise hand feature on Microsoft Teams. And of course, with this huge impact, there's also a huge business opportunity worth hundreds of billions of dollars. And with this importance, there is also a growing number of legal consequences that people can face if they neglect to care about accessibility. When it comes to app development and accessibility in app development, there are web content accessibility guidelines, which is a global accessibility standard and legal benchmark for both web and mobile accessibility. And they're based on these four guiding principles that apps should be perceivable, operable, understandable, and robust. And if you check out the guidelines at this link below, you can read up on all of the very specific guidelines on all of these different standards here. But all of guidelines and standards aside, empathy is truly the name of the game. It's important for us to explore the various accessibility settings and features of all the controls that we're working with, to be familiar with screen readers like TalkBack on Android, VoiceOver on iOS, and Narrator on Windows, and to research different accessibility models and APIs, and of course to test and leverage our available tools and resources. But where can you start? You can start with .NET MAUI today. With .NET MAUI, you'll be able to create accessible apps more seamlessly than ever before. And you can see here that our team has put in so much work into .NET MAUI and making .NET MAUI accessible as a mobile app framework, a desktop app framework, and just in general, overall. And so in .NET MAUI, we have introduced a set of new APIs called semantic properties, like semantic description, hint, and heading level that help us to instruct our screen readers what we want to be announced out loud. We also similarly have some semantic extensions APIs for setting the screen reader focus. We have a announce API as well for instructing, again, the screen reader what it should announce out loud. And if you're familiar with accessibility in Xamarin Forms, those same automation properties from Xamarin Forms are also available in .NET MAUI with a new addition of an Exclude with Children API as well. And of course, in addition to all of those new APIs we introduced in .NET MAUI, we've also worked to make .NET MAUI as accessible as possible out of the box without you having to worry about adding additional code in order to make it more accessible. So for example, you can see here with the tap gesture recognizer, font scaling, checkbox, and tabbing, we have made all these improvements and more. And of course, we have also worked to make sure that .NET MAUI is accessible with our accessibility validation process, and we're constantly looking for ways to improve as well. With all that being said, let's take a look at a .NET MAUI app and see all of this in practice. So you can see here, I have created a new MAUI app in VS Mac. I just went File, New, and created a .NET MAUI app, and this is the blank template we get right out of the box. You can see here we have an image with the .NET bot. We have a label, Hello World. We have another label under that that says Welcome to .NET Multiplatform App UI. And we have a Click Me button at the bottom. And if we look at the code behind, we can see that when this button is clicked, the count of this counter variable goes up, and we also update the button text accordingly to reflect the updated counter. And we also have a bunch of screen reader APIs. So we have here the semantic properties I mentioned. We have a semantic properties dot description on this image. So when I turn the screen reader on shortly, we will see that the screen reader reads aloud this description, cute.net bot waving hi to you. Without this, the image will not be detectable by the screen reader at all. So you can imagine for folks with visual impairments or who aren't able to see the screen whatsoever, the image would virtually not exist without this semantic properties dot description. We also have heading level property, which allows users to use the screen reader to skim content quickly. And we've used this heading level property on these two labels. And then on the button, we've used the semantic properties.hint to add additional screen reader text. So in addition to reading click me, it will read around count the number of times you click. And this is different from semantic properties.description. For example, in this label, you can see in addition to the text, we have a description, but it won't read out both. It will read out only the description here, which is virtually the same thing as the text, but we wanted to make sure that it will read out the text exactly as we wanted to. For example, we wanted to say .net rather than, for example, pause at the period. So I'm going to turn on the screen reader now on my Android device. Here I have a Pixel. So the screen reader I'm using is TalkBack.
TalkBack on. Focus on my demo. Boom.
So I've turned on TalkBack, the screen reader, and I'm going to tap through the various elements and you'll see everything I've just described to you.
Cube.net bot waving hi to you, image.
You see the semantic description read aloud.
Hello, world, heading.
You see this marked as a heading.
Welcome to .net multi-platform app UI, heading.
You see this one marked as a heading.
Click me button counts the number of times you click.
And you see the button double tap read out with both the text and the hint. And actually, if I tap on it again,
click me button counts the number of times you click. Double tap to activate.
You see, it also says double tap to activate. And this is something that the Android platform does for all buttons. Because it knows it is an interactive, it lets us know that we should double tap to activate. And if we look at the code behind again, we also have this announce API. So if I double tap to activate, the screen reader will also announce the updated text.
Click one time.
So not only is the clicked one time text updated on the button, but it also gets announced as well. So now I'm going to show you one more cool thing about heading. I mentioned earlier that the heading property allows screen reader users to skim the content. So if I use three fingers to horizontally swipe on my phone to switch to headings mode.
Links, windows, speech rate, spoken language, characters, words, lines, paragraphs, headings.
Okay, finally, we swipe made up or swipe it to headings. It says swipe up or swipe down to read by heading. So if I use one finger to swipe vertically, it will navigate to only the headings on the screen.
Welcome to .NET multi-platform app UI. Heading. Hello, world, heading.
So if I swipe up one more time, it won't go to the image.
No previous heading.
Similarly, if I come back down.
Welcome to .NET multi-platform app UI. Heading. No next heading.
It doesn't navigate below the headings. So you can see that how helpful headings can be if we have a bunch of text on our screen, for example. If we can navigate just by the headings, then that helps us to skim the content more quickly. I'm going to turn TalkBack back off now.
TalkBack off.
And so now that I've showed you how accessible this is right out of the box, I wanted to show you an example of, okay, you know, great, the Blink MAUI app template is accessible, but you know, there are more nuanced cases and more complex MAUI apps. How does the accessibility work there? Well, let's say, for example, then instead of this button, you have a custom button that you are using based on a stack layout label or some other control, and you add a tap gesture recognizer to it. And with a tap gesture recognizer, because you can add logic based on the tap event, that can allow you to see how it'll visually appear as a button. But normally, that won't also act as a button in terms of accessibility. You saw here how the screen reader read out double tap to activate. And we made sure that in .NET MAUI, if you do something like that, it'll also announce double tap to activate, which is not something that would normally occur. So as I described here, let's say instead of this button, I want to comment that out and I want to actually use a label control. So commented out the button and I'm going to introduce a label here, which is very similar to this button. Still reads click me, reads it with the same hint. And we have added a height request just because I want to make sure that the button or label is large enough so that we can actually tap on it. And I wanted to make sure it looks the same, so I added purple background, white text, and so forth. And then in the code behind, I want to add my tap gesture recognizer. So I'm going to grab my tap gesture recognizer code and I'm going to plop it in here. So since this button is no longer being used, since I commented out the button, I will also comment out this code. So I'm going to comment that out and then we'll add in the tap gesture recognizer code and make sure that we are applying it to the label we just created. So here we created a new tap gesture recognizer. We have the same exact logic as we did in the button and we have added the new tap gesture recognizer to apply to the counter label. So now if we run this code, you'll see that it looks pretty much the same as what we had. So this is what our app looked like originally. And then now here with the label, with the tap gesture recognizer, you can see that it looks slightly different, but essentially we make sure that it behaves exactly the same. So if I turn TalkBack on again, you can
click
see
me,
here,
the number of times you click. Double tap to activate.
When I clicked on the button, it says click me, double tap, click me.
Click me, counts the number of times you click.
Click me, counts the number of times you click, and it says double tap to activate again, which as I mentioned before, would only happen if it's a button. And we made sure that in MAUI, when you use a tap gesture recognizer, for example, that that is recognized. So as you can see, and as I've shown you, it's pretty easy to make your apps accessible with MAUI. We have the semantic properties, but we also took care of a lot of things for you so that even when you aren't adding extra accessibility related code, it is still pretty accessible. But beyond me telling you that it's accessible, how do you really know that I made this as accessible as I'm claiming to? Well, there is a tool that we like to use here at Microsoft called Accessibility Insights. And this is a tool that you can use on both Android and Windows at the moment. So since this is connected to my Pixel device, the software recognizes my phone. And when I click on Start Testing, I'm brought to this screen here. And this screen here shows us if there are any failed instances that it was able to check through its automation. So here you can see failed instances are 0. The second portion shows me how I can test my tap stops, which I won't be doing at the moment, but you can use this to check your keyboard accessibility. And then last but not least, on this final page, it lets me know if there's anything I need to review. And here you can see that there's nothing left for me to review. So that means the colors are accessible, the sizes of everything are a good accessible size, and the screen reader elements all have great screen reader labels. So I think we did a pretty great job making our accessible app. Thanks for going through this with me. And so as you can see, MAUI is pretty darn great when it comes to accessibility. We also have an accessibility blog post series that you can check out to learn more about all of this. And of course, we also have our Discord channel, MAUI Accessibility. Stay connected with us there. And of course, our GitHub repository for MAUI, where you can stay up to date on all of the latest things we're working on with regard to accessibility. Thank you.